I think that ultimately nations, societies, like individuals, act out of self-interest. And like individuals, nations and societies often have trouble figuring out where their self-interest lies.
You're assuming they're rational parties.
That's right. And so ultimately I believe that it will become clear that the path of least risk and highest return to both societies will come from an agreement in which they can live side by side in separate states in peace.
And do you also believe that the North Koreans will come to an agreement about what their own militaristic rhetoric, that it's not in their interest to even engage in that kind of rhetoric or those kinds of plans because they got too many other problems? Yeah. That there's a rational mind there that will suggest that there's more to be gained from negotiations than from conflict.
I didn't say, and I don't believe, that every mind is rational.
Okay.
And I didn't say, and I don't believe, that every government acts rationally. When you and I were younger, Barbara Tuchman wrote a great book called The March of Folly, which pointed out the many occasions
World
which government took actions directly contrary to their own interests. North Korea is a completely separate case, and there's no basis for comparing it with Israel
and
Palestine.
So therefore, that may be a place where a rational solution cannot be found.
It's a totalitarian society, dominated by the military, completely isolated. And one of the most amazing things, Charlie, when you go around the world and meet leaders of as many countries as I have, is to see how often they are misinformed, uninformed, almost delusional about the circumstances in which they find themselves in.